So Andrew was assessing Reza's English, and he'd got a picture of a street scene and he was pointing to things. And Reza was answering, "Oh, it's a car, it's a lorry, it's a bus, no problem." Then Andrew pointed to some traffic lights. And Reza said, "Red, stop. Green, go." Okay. So immediately we could see lots of issues with his English. One of the ones that struck me was the fact that the word traffic is very much more difficult than the words car, bus and lorry. So the names of individual objects are moderately easy to learn, but group nouns, like traffic, much more difficult. Similarly, table and chair are easy, furniture much more difficult. Knife, fork and spoon, easy enough. Cutlery, much more difficult. House, school, shop, okay. Buildings, more difficult. In this little mini-series about words, I'm trying to alert you to the various difficulties that we put in front of children learning EAL. And group nouns is one of them. Another group of problematic words are words like pen. Now, of course, ideally, one would show a real object. And of course, you can't possibly show a pen to the children. I mean, just the smell and the sheep dung that's around would not really be nice to bring into the classroom, especially when you think about the size of it as well. And I'm joking with you, of course. The problem with the word pen is it has two different meanings. And I've just suggested to you that it might be a sheep pen, as well as the pen you write with. But don't forget, a pen is also a female swan. So we think the children have learnt a word, and they have only learnt part of it. And when they see sheep pen, they may well be thinking of a thing that the sheep write with. Very peculiar. We must remember words that have got two or more meanings. Hand, of course, we think of this. You've got to remember hands on the face of a clock. Sink, well, that we have sinks in schools, we wash our hands at them. So what happens when a boat sinks? It's difficult for us to know. And I've got the word sleep here. And we know what the word sleep is. And so those kind people who help tired dogs by putting them to sleep. We've got to remember all the time that many words have got two, three, four or even more meanings. And that raises difficulties for children learning EAL. Just the last example I've got is the word can, because that's got lots of different meanings as well. Can I go to the toilet? That's asking for permission. I can jump? That's talking about ability. And it can get cold at night. Well, that's looking at possibility, isn't it? Okay, so words have two or more meanings. We have to teach each of the meanings, not just the first one.